Mr. Vallabh Bhanshali is the chairman and co-founder Enam Securities Private Limited. Enam has been involved in some of the most innovative and pioneering capital market and advisory transactions in the country. Enam has played a significant role in development of leading business houses and was voted the best domestic equity house several times. Recently, Enam merged its investment banking business with Axis Bank. He is the ex-chairman and trustee of the Global Vipassana Foundation. He founded FLAME, India's innovative liberal arts university. Mr. Bhanshali is also a member of SEBI's Primary Market Advisory Committee. He is developing methods and courses that would present India's ancient and scientific wisdom using a modern metaphor. Ladies and gentlemen, get ready to take a leap into the world of financial supermarkets with Mr. Vallabh Bhanshali. Let us extend him a warm welcome.
Good afternoon. It was easy to find that Munjal Sahab Delhi se aaye the, isn't it? It was such a rousing speech. And you know, when it comes to my topic, actually I had been asked what will I speak on. So I suggested two topics. And what typical mentality we have is ki yaar dono le lo to acha hai. So I want to tell you a story. Many years ago, a glamour queen of her times went up to George Bernard Shaw. And he says, I want to meet you privately. So behind the stage, she met him. He said, I want to marry you. So Shaw was, of course, a great man. We know that. So he was a nonplussed, but he said, okay, we'll think about it. But why? He said, no, you're such an intelligent man. I'm such a pretty person. Our children will be fantastic because they will be pretty like me and intelligent like you. So Shaw thought for a second. He said, what if it turns out the other way? So sometimes when you mix topics, you don't know what you will get, but here the organizers in their wisdom. So I think it will be, you will be the best judge as to what the outcome of this mixed topics is. And I also wish, like my friend Sunil ji, I could crowdsource the topic. You know, he just sourced all the questions and it was easy for him. But, you know, I heard this is called India 2.0. And what I think is, you know, India, most of the people are Hindus, and I don't mean to be religious or sectarian really, but you know, we have this great epic or great book, Bhagavad Gita, which says, Paditranaya Sadhunam Vinashaya Chatushkadam Dharma Sansthapanarthayam, right? We have had so many avatars of Vishnu, which means, which is the next version actually, because the things have taken a mess and we have been relaunched by every avatar. So this country has been reinventing itself for a very long time, and obviously last 250 years have been very dark. And absolutely no doubt that we will come back. So, good news is, you know, I mean, there were a lot of questions and a lot of frustrations, so I want to begin on a more positive note that India is in a very, very good place. Very, very good place. I'm an investor, so I invest in companies when they're still not magnificent. They're still only promising, and I think India is a very, very promising country, and you've seen the whole world come here. And why? I think our fantastic Prime Minister puts it very nicely. I call it Modi's 3D, which is demand, demographics, and democracy. And they do mean a lot, and I think I heard at least two speakers talk about it, so I'll move on. Additional benefits are coming to us from two things. Low energy costs, which is here to stay, not only because oil prices have crashed. Some people would like to think that they have been manipulated to crashing. I don't know. because what do I know about manipulation? The second is that we are amongst the highest interest rate countries in the world, and we are a significant economy, so I think there's a good chance that interest rates will also come down, resulting in a lower cost economy, which is obviously a great advantage. The other thing which is moving in the lower direction is the involvement of the government. Again, Munjalji lives in Delhi, knows much more than people in Bombay. So he's saying that the laws, the number of laws that are likely to be scrapped or altered for use of doing business is very good. So I think India is changing. It's a big ship. So when it moves, you don't notice it immediately. But a huge shift has already taken place. I agree with him completely that British left a system of bureaucracy which didn't always work for us. And I heard a story, and I won't give you the source, and also I can share it. Very interesting how the bureaucratic mind works. So there are some fantastic ministers, so I'm told that he had a long meeting, very inspiring meeting, and he said, we can do this much and we can bring about this change. And so after a couple of hours, everyone was very convinced that, look, all this can be done. So one of the bureaucrats thought, अरे यार अगर ये कल हो सकता है तो why didn't it happen yesterday? There must be a good reason why it didn't happen yesterday. Let's find the reason why it didn't happen yesterday and then start discussing that. So bureaucrats have a great mindset, and I hope that we have seen some harsh action on this front and we will see good things. One last thing, as a result of the hodgepodge that I was given, let me give you a global perspective. And I call, we heard about BRICS, and unfortunately the BRICS crumbled. Russia is gone, Brazil is in difficulty. There is a new combination in the world, that's how I like to think, which is CIA. It's just a good CIA, it's not the US CIA, which is China, India, America. Three largest population countries with the most stable governments, with a lot of things going in their favor. China doesn't have as favorable demographics as India and US, but Chinese government is probably, and there is no statistic to say that, is the most proactive, very, very determined government that, they immediately tackle their problems and do something about it. So those who remember 2008, people thought after the Olympics, this is all Olympics growth. After Olympics, growth will vanish, but China has been able to maintain. So let me move on. We talked about change and we talked about opportunities, a lot of young people here. And I know there are a lot of the older people who are even more ambitious than young people. So I think it's not about young and old, it's about ambition to do something. Some of the big things that happened in the last 20, 30 years in the world, and you probably heard their names called internet, telecommunication, so on. I like to think of them differently. So some of that goes to our rustic capability. कि किसी के यहाँ शादी होती थी, बहुत मेहमान आते थे. तो पुराने जमाने में होटल एंड धर्मशाला एक होती थी, पर बोले पड़ोसी का तो रूम खाली है, उसके यहाँ चला जाए. So we thought of redundancy. That there are so many unused assets around us, but we never thought about it in an organized manner. Internet was the first major insight into redundancy. That how in the Second World War somebody thought of using all the multiple telephone lines to basically create secret messaging. 30 years later, 40 years later, it became a revolution. Actually, what is it? It is redundancy. The lines are there, how can you use them? And now this redundancy has become a huge revolution. Let me give you another example and you will connect with it immediately. What is Uber? Uber is not new cars, not new taxis. It is people who are ready to offer their car and services if they are free. You heard about, all this travel website, right? What are they doing? Planes have seats. Somebody just looking at the redundancy and says, okay, why don't I offer them for cheap? It is because there are young and imaginative people. Think of redundancy. It's a massive, massive trend. Second is global reach. So today, do anybody knows who was the founder of WhatsApp? Anybody can give me the name here? Which country? Come on, guys. Ukraine. His name was Jan Koum, right? The man who was on food stamps. So can you imagine a country like Ukraine? Most people can't put, you know, their finger on it on the map. Now, maybe because of Russian war, they know that Russia ke aaspaas hoga. But from there, to think of something, it's a simple application, it's a worldwide phenomenon. So what you do is not local anymore. It can easily become global, again, because of the digital platform. Third, free. Prasad ke alawa kuch free nahi hota tha. In this internet world, things are free. And so your search is free. YouTube is free. And so on. So many things were made free. And it is very difficult for a typical businessman to think, yeah, free mein vyapar kaise hota hai? But you know enough models. Fourth, free created networks and so on. It created something very interesting, which probably there is no history to show that something like this happened ever before. And that was that when you created things and you allowed people to consume, they also became producers. Can anyone quickly turn this around and tell me how? That the consumer became the producer. Say, for example, when Google created YouTube platform, who is producing the content? Google is not producing the content. We are producing the content. Anybody just picks, and the most phenomenal amount of collection of all social networks are what? Someone has just created a platform. We are producing our data on it. Somebody is analyzing the data, so we are the producers. So a very interesting phenomenon of that kind has happened. So what do you need to do? Gyan bahut ho gaya, kaam ki baat. What can I take home? A few things. Think new. There are a lot of old problems. There are a lot of issues. But if you start thinking of new things, there's much greater hope. And I'm trying to give you some XI. You understand X's, right? X axis, Y axis. I'm trying to give you some XI. Not because I have anything to do with Axis Bank, but and new has always meant a good business opportunity. Nahi ice cream ki dukaan hai, nahi saari ki dukaan hai, it is done always one. The difficulty is that new in the past lasted a long time. Ek baar naya kuch jam gaya, to gaadi chal rahi hai. And that's why we had another interesting phenomenon. And that phenomenon was, गांव में किसी ने एक धंधा शुरू किया, कुछ ठीक ठाक चला, everyone wanted to do the same business. So Indore is very famous कि how soya, how leasing, and you know everything got copied multiple times. But the difficulty now is that new does not last for very long. New finishes very fast. You remember, some of you may remember, not the youngsters really, how big Yahoo was. There were offers to buy Yahoo for, you know, a large amount of money. They declined and the value fell. So however big, you can fall very quickly. So new is a must. Secondly, how we used to think of it was, we were a supply-starved world, right? So Sunil ji talked about ki har cheez ka license hota tha. So it was not only in India, but around the world that a better product was not easily available. Humko import karna padta tha. But after China, somehow this has changed dramatically, that there is no more shortage of goods. As a combination of all this, what has happened is that consumer is in the center. Everyone is out to please the consumer. Some of the older people, they find it difficult. But I think there's no choice, that you have to think of giving him more and more. So how does one think about new, besides just being new as a paradigm? Think of a new process. What did Flipkart do? Flipkart is not, they are only retailing. Yeah, but retailing in a new way. The process of doing it is different. And so it's a very simple thing. They didn't invent it. It was new to India. Today they are a $12 billion company, the largest brick or, you know, brick and mortar retail company is worth probably less than $2 billion. So how quickly Flipkart was able to create that. Another example I want to give you, that if you can think of process, take Apple. So they created iTunes. Now, iTunes is creating more profit for Hollywood than Hollywood put together. It's so large. Profit from iTunes, the revenue of iTunes is $10 billion. All that they did is they created a platform from which you can buy music and other stuff. There are also free universities and all. A lot of people may not be aware, but iTunes University is one of the fantastic places to go to. And they created an app world. That why should I alone make, you know, gadgets or things that can work on this? So they created the app world. Now a lot of other people also created app world. Together, of course, this is fantastic. But someone was talking of jobs. The number of jobs that Apple has created by this infrastructure, this change of process, is 650,000 jobs, staggering amount of jobs. And the last one they have done, I'm sure there are more to come from them, is iPay, where, you know, they use the iTunes platform. So, you know, how you pay, the process of paying is changing. Product, of course, is easier to think of, that you come up with new products. So you have gadgets coming out all the time and, you know, taking our breath away. But yet another way of thinking of new is not in thinking in terms of physical product, but looking at the physical product or service as a bundle of value. That what if you add something to the bundle and what if you remove something from the bundle, you have a dramatically new product. And let me give you an example again. Now I think it's popular wisdom, but who is the largest camera selling company in the world? Right, Samsung or any of the phone selling companies. What did they do? They bundled the phone with the camera. So there used to be an electronic diary separately. We used to have multiple devices. They were all becoming bundle of value. At the same time, somebody is thinking, what can I remove from the bundle? So no frills travel came. You want to take a plane ride? Why should I serve you food? Why should I have J class? Why don't I have this, that, etc.? So you take a bundle of values and break it, change it, combine things. It becomes a very interesting thing. In various areas, this has happened. Think of food. Or take up a hotel room. Right? Earlier, say until 10 years ago, the hotel room did not have toiletries. Then they found ki bahut thoda sa rupiya lagta hai, but it makes the traveler free ki mujhe toilet kit vagara ghar se lane ki zarurat nahi hai. So we have travel slippers, we have a bathrobe in many hotels. So people are seeing that how do I change the consumer experience by thinking of this value. It is not that expensive, it is just this insight. Similarly, food. The packaged food is one thing, and similarly providing victuals, right? In Bombay at least we have that. That on the internet you can go and you say that Sanjay Kapoor or whosoever is the top chef and this dish is very famous. I want to cook that at home. Can you send me all the victuals and the recipe? For five people, they'll deliver a pack to you. So if you break that into bundle of values, service. Again, people who have had the background in supply-starved economies, service kaun deta tha? अच्छे मुंह बात भी नहीं करते थे लोग ग्राहक से अब वो तो होने लगा बट थोड़ी दुकान ठीक चलती है एंड पीपल आर एरोगेंट गॉन आर दोस डेज दैट पीपल बेंड बैकवर्ड्स टू सर्व द सक्सेस ऑफ फ्लिपकार्ट नॉट ओनली इज इन क्रिएटिंग अ डिजिटल प्लेटफॉर्म बट दे एडेड सर्विस टू रिटेल एक्सपीरियंस विच डिडंट एग्जिस्ट सच एज स्टूडेंट्स गिव मी एग्जांपल्स एक्सक्यूज मी सॉरी Then I am asking Flipkart, what is the service layer they created? Cash on delivery. So you bought a credit on credit card, but they say, nahi, aapke ghar aayega. Second, making the returns very easy. You want to return something which we didn't have. This has been done abroad, but they brought this, you know, as a service to India. And this shortage of time, so I won't go into, but there are many examples of this kind. Yet another way of thinking of service, which is becoming increasingly important for big companies, is, am I an environment-friendly company? It's a service to the society I'm doing. So you'll find body shops saying, we do not indulge in any cruelty to animals. Or there are other companies which will advertise or, you know, make a statement similarly. CSR. So there are many companies which will say, 0.5% of my revenue will go to a CSR or a, you know, social cause. So I'm giving you various dimensions that it is possible to think of new things. To the extent, I will say, is such a brave new world that if you have to look for business ideas, you have to only wish it. You can't imagine the kind of companies that have come into being, right? So you know who is Elon Musk? Tesla car, right? So what else has he done? Right? SpaceX. So we can't imagine ki, you know, who will want to go to space, but two smart guys like Richard Branson and him are doing it. And the number of companies that are, you know, participating in that is fantastic. So, you know, I would imagine that ki mujhe kahin hotel, I want to go for a holiday, we all wished ki wo jagah kaisi hai, koi mujhe bata de. So we call up uncle, auntie, friends, neighbor, etc. You had been to Gulmarg last year, where did you stay? They created TripAdvisor. So there are service after service after service, which is, you know, you wish something was there. If you search the internet, you will find there. Or maybe there are entrepreneurs who are building such businesses. The amount of work just being done on the front field of energy is phenomenal. And one of the biggest things is that, you know, we have solar energy. We have wind energy. We have, you know, the waves of the ocean energy. The earth is moving all the time. So we have geothermal energy. The biggest problem with all of them is, how do you store that energy? Din mein to Surya Bhagwan aake chale gaye, uski energy to khatam ho gayi. So how do I store this energy? One of the smartest guys working on it is again Elon Musk, correcting, making a battery out of it. So field after field, this is happening. The other thing that needs to be done is, of course, quick. As I said, the new doesn't last a long time, and you have to think very quickly. And those who are able to do that, they are big winners. Last 2-3 days, such a big winner emerged. An Indian brand that has taken on global brands quickly. Micromax. What is their claim? Both all of these, if you'll notice, they are putting more value and they are very quick. The speed with which Micromax launches new editions is unmatched in the world, and they took on Samsung. So all this is real, and this is being done by people who are entrepreneurs. Maruti chairman was telling me that the market is such that the number of models they want to launch in the next 5 years will be more than what they have launched in all the 33 years so far. Can you imagine? 5 years will be more than 33 years. So you have to be very, very quick. Another consequence of combination of all this, that WhatsApp is not Ukrainian. WhatsApp is not, you know, there are a lot of other things which are not Japanese or Chinese. They become global very quickly. So local is the new global, or global is the new local. Things become very, very big, very fast. And unless it becomes big, probably it will die, or it will not sustain for a long time. And I'll give you one big example of it, that how big boys are thinking that coming together is very important. There are many management students. There is an infrastructure company in the country, very valuable one, which has been created by 3 competitors. Quickly, Bharti Airtel. I'm sorry, Bharti Infratel, right? Is the telecom tower company where Vodafone, Idea, and Airtel have come together. Ki bhaiya paise bachane hain, jaldi se network karna hai. So they all got together. They put their towers and they're building new towers. More recently, last 3 days again, another example came up. You would have read about a lot of people applying for a banking license for what is called the payment bank. Do you remember that? There were 70 applications, and that had all the big boys, Reliance, Videocon, Dilip Sanghvi, and so on. And most of them are partnerships. If you think of the partnership which attracted my attention was Reliance and State Bank of India. Now, why would State Bank of India need a license, and why would they need Reliance to do payments bank? We can't even imagine. And if you can't imagine, you're missing out on what is happening in this world, and therefore, you're reducing a chance of your success. So you'll find all the big boys, they are combining. Which means what? At one end, your competition has become immense. And in Modi's government, as the government goes down, as you say, smaller government and bigger on governance. So once the government goes down, you're going to get more and more competition. But the nature of competition is also changing. And it is changing to co-opetition, that how do I cooperate? So protocols in technology, those who understand, or associations, or even partnerships are coming up. Question is, I am not like Arun Nanda, who took an MBA at 57. And a lot of you probably would be like me, not very dynamic, etc. And so, kya karenge? So you try and get that talent. Because the talent's definition now is what? Can you think smart? Can you think new? Not enough. Can you think quick? Not enough. Can you think big? Not many people can do that. So wherever the default assumption is, ye IIT ka hai, to isko aata hoga, ye IIM ka aata hoga, so they are getting what? Crores and crores of rupees salary. Why? Because these are the kids of whom the expectation is that they will think big, new, etc., etc. This has been happening in America for a long time. You know where such guys ended up in America most typically? Where? On the Wall Street. They paid the best dollars for all the super bright kids. And what did they make them do? Trade on the markets. So they created bundles and derivatives and this and that. Some of them went into research and this, that, etc. also. But what happened? As the one good side has been that, now I have the water, sorry. That while they created big banks, they also created big bangs of difficulty. So the scams, right? We have had scams here also. Some of these people who got big, quick, very quickly, unfortunately, from my market. And there are a lot of other markets, so our market is not the only one. And I don't know if Indore se bhi koi hai ki nahi hai. But so the talent has had its downside also. And why this downside? And I want to give it a different direction. As a matter of fact, we are not thinking enough of how you can be big naturally and how you can be big unnaturally. So whenever you try and become big unnaturally, something goes wrong. Something else was going wrong for some of the longest period of time. And you know what? You heard about the LIBOR crisis? That 3 years ago, it was discovered that the most used interest rate in the world was the London Interbank Offer Rate, or LIBOR. And billions and trillions of dollars were given and exchanged based on the rate. And the rate was manipulated and fixed. And there were banks who were making killings, absolutely, being done by talented people. But it was not only talented people. The moral problem was much greater, not only at the talent level. आजकल तो हमारे जैसे थोड़े ग्रे या बिना बाल के लोग आएंगे एंड विल गिव लेक्चर्स कि बच्चों को एथिक्स सिखाना चाहिए. द बिगर एथिकल प्रॉब्लम हैज बीन एट द टॉप. कोई इसको मालूम तो नहीं पड़ेगा ना, ठीक है चलने दे. सो इट्स अ सीरियस इश्यू. अमेरिका इज अ ग्रेट कंट्री एंड दे हैव रिकग्नाइज्ड दिस लॉट मोर देन अस. सो देयर आर टू प्रॉब्लम्स दैट व्हेन द टैलेंट गोज हेवायर, इट ऑफ कोर्स will do damage to society. But they recognized, this man is sick. He doesn't recognize that he has done how much harm to himself. Right? We heard about Rajat Gupta, or we heard about Rajaratnam, or we heard about Stephen Cohen, a lot of these other people who are absolutely brilliant people. And I met all of them. They are amazingly brilliant people who could charm anybody in the world. Why couldn't they see that this is a disaster waiting to happen? So something else has started. And that is they recognized that we live in two planes, the animate or the conscious plane and the inanimate or the matter world. While we claim to be far superior, and Sunilji started on one of my favorite topic of, you know, because my, you know, the version that came out here of my introduction, it did pick up that I'm very fascinated by India's ancient wisdom, but we have to give it a modern metaphor and we have to present it in a modern idiom. So they recognize this. Hum khali kitab sar pe rakke chalte hain. They have taken the wisdom out and they're doing the same thing. You know, one of the biggest trends in management training and management practices in the cutting edge companies in America now is what is called mindfulness. Aap check karo aapka mind ja kahan raha hai. That itself, it's a Buddhist practice, which has probably been culled out of the Vipassana practice, which has been, you know, a revolution for the last 40, 45 years. Just mindfulness. The same thing is being done on medicine. Ki sharir theek kaise hota hai? So they recognize now that by and large, no medicine works. The medicine depends on the power of the body to give it a push, to do something, but yet it leaves a lot of debris which will go and collect in the liver or the lung or the brain or somewhere wrong, in kidneys. And so quietly, the amount of research which is being done on immunity is immense. Ki body ki immunity kaise chalti hai? Is immunity ko badha dein, body will get cured, body will be able to fight anything and everything. So, I mean, this is the wisdom that we already had. But so this is thinking of consciousness at multiple levels. And so I want to sum up. I haven't got a slip or a reminder, and I'm not even looking back. But what to do is to think new, to think in terms of value bundles, to think in terms of new as a process. And you know what? And I was thinking about talking today, and I said, I'm coming to Indore. One of the largest businesses in Indore traditionally for centuries has been what? Agriculture, right? Agriculture ki badi jabardast mandi hai. Shipra Nadi aspas, you know, I mean, you have such fertile land all around. And if India is lagging behind, and if we are backward, we are amongst the most backward in dealing with our agriculture. The way food production moves from one state to the other state, from one mandi to the other mandi, there is something called this, you know, what is called Agricultural Produce Market Committee, APMC, there is some act. It is so archaic, it's unbelievable. So while Sunilji talked about, you know, this agricultural potential, if you look at the infrastructure, it's most horrible. So if you just apply your mind to thinking of process right here, and if you don't, you can get killed. And let me give you an example how you get killed. You remember Yellow Pages? Bade Yellow Pages dikhe. There used to be classified in the newspapers. It's all gone. Internet has just killed it. Google took Yellow Pages. Google is nothing but Yellow Pages. Thought through. Kya aapko kya chahiye? There's a listing, very simple listing, and cut and dice 20 different ways, or 40 different ways, 1,000 different ways. Another business that died probably as a result of this. So anyway, I'll go on to say process. Think of value bundle. Think big, think quick, talent. So talent is difficulty here. The talent has so far been thought of as a talent of head. It's increasingly talent of heart. That Arun, my friend, was talking in the morning, darna mat, paise lagao. Factory lagane mein dar lagta hai, satta karne mein dar nahi lagta. This is not easy. When so much change is happening around you, how do you have this heart which will be courageous? A Yan Kum, who lived on food stamps, didn't give up his dream. Guys who drop out of their colleges, they have a special heart. Yaar, daddy ne to bola tha MBA kar le, lekin yaar, I don't have the patience, I'll jump out of it and I'll do whatever I want. It's a special skill. Are we training our children? And I want to share one very poignant story. And since there are a lot of management graduates, some parents here. In one of the award ceremonies in Bombay, probably the most important award ceremony, Bini Bansal of Flipkart won the award. So when he came to get his, made his acceptance speech, he didn't talk about Flipkart at all. He just saw ke yahan kafi bure log baithe hain. He said, I have an appeal to make. He said, in my journey so far, I had many difficulties. But you know which was the biggest difficulty? Was persuading any young person to work for us. कि वो माँ बाप या बीवी बोलती थी अरे यार कहाँ जा रहा है कल तो तेरी नौकरी बंद हो जाएगी. सो द सोसाइटी इज सो रिस्क अवर्स कि नहीं स्टार्टअप के लिए काम नहीं करना. एंड अनलेस आवर कंट्री कैन गेट टू द कल्चर ऑफ स्टार्टअप्स. सो आई मेड अ प्रेजेंटेशन रिसेंटली एट सम अदर यू नो कॉन्क्लेव एंड आई मेड दिस प्रेजेंटेशन एंड देयर इज अ वेरी फेमस रिपोर्ट अवेलेबल that 18% of all jobs in the US in the last 20 years were created by startups, not the Dows and not the Shells and not the big companies. It was all done by startups. And 43% of all startups were done by Indians in America, at least in the high-tech area. So if the Indian contribution is this, the seven next together do not match India's contribution, Indian's contribution in the US. I don't know what's happening in India. So I think I gave you some generic paradigms to think about doing this, but you need a lot of qualities ahead. Lastly, talent has also become hand. And aaj achha massage karne wala uska bada daam hai. Beautician hai uska bada daam hai. Actor hai uska bada daam hai. So the world is a wonderful place where talent has got redefined completely. And there are smart companies who are thinking of talent differently and who are going to change the game. And so, you know, take Arun Nanda's story, right? He was not a Mahindra, but Mahindra invested in Arun Nanda, who created $1 billion. I think particularly in a small town where typically we have SMEs, you know, small and medium enterprise, ghar ka aadmi bahut important lagta hai. Ghar ka aadmi nahi to koi bharosa nahi hota. घर का आदमी है तो आपका ग्रोथ भी लिमिटेड होगा. सो हाउ यू क्रिएट सिस्टम प्रोसेस प्रिडिक्टेबिलिटी रेप्लिकेबिलिटी स्केलेबिलिटी एक्सेट्रा बिना टैलेंट कल्टीवेशन के नहीं होता है. सो आई डू वांट यू टू थिंक वेरी डिफरेंटली अबाउट टैलेंट अबाउट योर सेल्फ एज टैलेंटेड पर्सन एंड इवन यू वॉन्ट टू हायर. एंड ऑफकोर्स द नीड टू नो योर सेल्फ टू गेट ऑन टू द कॉन्शियसनेस प्लेन इज ओनली गोइंग टू बिकम इट इज ऑलवेज वेरी बिग वी ऑल नो इट. But maybe like everything else, just a yoga, America se yahan wapis aaya, this practices of consciousness, meditation, etc. Again, we are going to learn from America. If you can just beat them, beat Americans to it and start doing it and understanding this, it'll be wonderful, I can tell you. It's been my personal experience. Thank you for your patient hearing. Very much.